Ajoy Mehta Ji, Dr. Jha, friends, congratulations to all the students who participated in the competition and especially the winners. And we should first of all give a big hand to the two persons who are instrumental in getting this competition off the ground, executing it and bringing it to this point. That is my colleague Saili and Prachi. Friends, we would have liked to have Shri Nitin Karir from the government of Maharashtra also present at this function. He had agreed, but he had to go out of the city, because the learnings of this competition are relevant, as Dr. Jha mentioned, for cities beyond Mumbai, in fact, beyond Maharashtra. And we do hope that the state government takes this report seriously. This competition is just a very small example of participative governance. In one aspect of policy formulation, that is DP, development plan, and a very small part of the civil society that got engaged, that was invited to participate, that's the student community. Nevertheless, a very commendable initiative. But we have gathered here, first of all, as Dr. Jha said, to rejoice, to felicitate these young students, but also to look at the broader theme of reimagining civic governance. And the keynote address that Shri Ajoy Mehta delivered today is very hope-giving. He was candid, of course, very articulate, and very educative. And if you have officers like him and the kind of decisions that he mentioned that the corporation has taken, then we can say that governance will become less of a bad word. But it's not just governance that's a bad word, but there's something related to governance that's an even more of a bad word, and that's politics. In fact, people have now got used to politics synonymous to manipulation, intrigue. Oh, wo to bahut politics karta hai. Us organization bahut politics chalta hai. So, if our democracy has to become healthier, governance more effective, then politics also needs to be reimagined. Politics for civic good governance. And that's, of course, a completely separate issue. But friends, the need for participation, citizens' participation in municipal governance. First of all, it's because those in government do not have a monopoly over ideas. And therefore, they have a responsibility, an obligation to reach out to those in civil society that have good ideas. It's especially important because governance is becoming very complex. The issues that we are required to tackle, the corporation is required to tackle, be it water supply, primary health care, tertiary health care, primary education, sanitation, these are all very, very complex issues. And most municipal bodies are not doing a good job. And this is by no means a remark on the person who is the executive head of the corporation. Oh, no, sure. Then why don't we do one thing?
No, I'll just rush because the DP is being discussed in the general body and they want me there. This very thing is being discussed there in the corporation.
Sure, sure.
Can I take you
a Yeah, sure. Let's give him a big hand. Friends, we need participative governance, first of all, so that the ideas that academic institutions have, students have, professionals have, they flow into governance. But there is a far more fundamental reason why governance has to be participative. And that has to do with the relationship between state and society. In democracy, state belongs to the people. It's not the people who belong to the state. People should be regarded, and society should be regarded as an integral part of the state structure. State is not superior to society. Unfortunately, it has become superior to society, and which is why citizens are afraid of going close to the state, especially the law enforcement wings of the state. Aap kisse bhi puchiye ki police station jana hai, to log ghabrate hain. Because the state has imagined itself and is functioning itself in a manner where it believes that it is superior to society. That has to change. The municipal commissioner has left, but even in his absence, I would like to give a few suggestions and ideas to his colleagues here. We are talking about reimagining civic governance. To take this small initiative forward, I would urge the Municipal Corporation of Mumbai, first of all, to have its own think tank. All great cities in the world, they have their own think tanks, be it Shanghai, London, Tokyo, Istanbul. And we at ORF have interacted with some of them. Mumbai needs to have its own think tank. You know, some of our state governments have a think tank, and let me tell you, friends, that we at the Observer Research Foundation have recently collaborated with Mumbai University in establishing Mumbai School of Economics and Public Policy. So the university will also now function as an institution for public policy making. There are so many academic institutions in the city, IIT, TISS, great colleges. So the corporation should reach out to academic institutions. And for doing this, it should have an institution of its own, a think tank of its own. And we at the Observer Research Foundation, I have already communicated this to the municipal commissioner, we are willing to participate and to work closely with the corporation. Of course, there are many other think tanks coming up. So this new think tank culture should be nurtured in Mumbai. Secondly, the municipal commissioner mentioned capacity building. And one of the truly commendable initiatives the corporation has taken under Dr. Jha's leadership is to start an institute for training and capacity building for the first time in Mumbai. And I asked Dr. Jha before the function began, when is it going to become functional? And he said he hopes that it gets inaugurated on Gandhi Jayanti, October 2. A new building has been identified. It's being spruced up. And this center for institute for training capacity building should not be only for MCGM. Firstly, it should be for all the municipal bodies in the metropolitan region, MMR region. And I'm told that there are 9 or 10 municipal corporations and many more municipal councils in the MMR region, the Mumbai Municipal Mumbai metropolitan region, which is in terms of size, area, it is 10 times bigger than BMC or MCGM. But we have to think of MMR as an organic whole. There is no real difference between Mumbai, Navi Mumbai, Thane, Kalyan, etc. So this new institute should become an institute for training capacity building for the entire MMR region, for other urban local bodies in Maharashtra, but it should aspire to become a premier training and capacity building institute for the entire country. If we say that Mumbai is a premier city of India, it should aspire to provide this service to the entire country because it's a national need today. One more suggestion. Our corporation, friends, is very poor in projecting itself either to the citizens of Mumbai or to the rest of the world. Just look at the website of BMC. How many of you have seen visit the BMC website? Please do so and compare it with the websites of other great cities in the world, and you'll see the difference. Why can't the corporation reach out to professionals, ask them to design it better, populate it with better content, and most importantly, not just in English and Marathi? There should be information if the city really belongs to all, and the people should feel that the corporation belongs to all. The corporation should also provide information in other languages, like Hindi, Gujarati, Urdu. You know, I once made a suggestion to Ajay Mehta. If you see the headquarters of the corporation, have you noticed that the name of the building, it is only in Marathi? It's not in English. Brihan Mumbai Mahanagar Palika. Why can't, you know, it's an iconic building of Mumbai. Why shouldn't it be at least in English? So our city belongs to all should belong to the city, and our city is diverse. And that diversity should be reflected in the way the corporation projects itself to its own citizens and to the world at large. Reimagining civic governance and disruptive, Dr. Jha mentioned, it should be disruptive. Now, what can be more disruptive than the simple fact that the city corporation and the mayor of the city should truly be empowered? Do we have an empowered mayor today? You know, just compare the mayor of London, Sadiq Khan, is known all over the world. He's an empowered mayor. Even Donald Trump takes notice of Sadiq Khan. How many citizens of Mumbai know even the name of the mayor of Mumbai? Shouldn't we have an empowered mayor so that the duality that Dr. Jha was talking about is removed? Mumbai, even though it remains in Maharashtra, why shouldn't Mumbai have its own city governance, city government? Very recently, the government of Maharashtra has taken a good step of saying that the sarpanch should be directly elected by the people of a village. Good step. But why not the mayor of Mumbai elected directly by the people of Mumbai? So let's be ambitious. What Dr. Jha said, you know, if we propose some ideas, they may not get picked up now, but maybe 10 years hence, 20 years hence, if we really want Mumbai to change, we should go for bold ideas, go for ambitious ideas, and keep on hammering that just the demand that we need an empowered mayor, an empowered executive, doesn't mean that we want to take Mumbai out of Maharashtra. All this false propaganda, this has to stop. So friends, there are so many issues that are part of this broad theme of reimagining civic governance. We've just made a beginning, and as Saili said, we hope that the corporation takes this initiative forward, involves stakeholders, professionals, academics, others in governance, in policy formulation, in monitoring the execution, even in regulation. That is when people feel in that the corporation belongs to us, government belongs to us, and that is true democracy, friends. Thank you very much. We have a full hall that has remained full even until the end of the program. So thank you very much, friends.